Hello students, welcome to Vaijanti Study. Today I am going to teach you question answers from our English textbook Honeydew. Chapter: The Best Christmas Present in the World. Question number 1. What did the author find in a junk shop? The author found a very old 19th century roll top desk in a junk shop. It was made of oak. It was in a bad condition, so it was being sold at a cheap price. Question number 2. What did he find in a secret drawer? Who do you think had put it in there? Answer is, in a secret drawer of the roll top desk, the author found a small tin box. There was a letter in that box. Connie, the wife of Jim MacPherson, must have put it there. Who had written the letter to whom and when? Jim MacPherson was a captain of the British Army. He wrote this letter while fighting the German forces. The letter was dated December 26, 1914. It was addressed to his wife, Connie. Question number 4. Why was the letter written? What was the wonderful thing that had happened? Answer is, the letter was written to describe a wonderful incident. It occurred on the Christmas day of 1914. The wonderful thing was that the two armies fighting against each other had celebrated Christmas together. The initiative was taken by the Germans. First they shouted Happy Christmas to the English from the no man's land. The English responded with same to you. This encouraged the Germans. They waved a white flag and crossed the no man's land to reach the English camp. Once together, they were very happy. Question number 5. What jobs did Hans Wolf and Jim MacPherson have when they were not soldiers? Hans Wolf played the cello in the orchestra when he was not a soldier. Jim MacPherson was a teacher in Dorset when not a soldier. Question number 6. Had Hans Wolf ever been to Dorset? Why did he say he knew it? No, Hans Wolf had never been to Dorset. He had been reading English books. Hardy was his favorite author. Hardy's novel, Far From the Madding Crowd, was his favorite book. This book describes Dorset. So Hans Wolf said he knew Dorset well. Question number 7. Do you think Jim MacPherson came back from the war? How do you know this? Answer is, MacPherson never came back from the war. His wife Connie knew about his death. That was why she kept the letter in a tin box. She wrote on the top of the box that it was Jim's last letter. Question number 8. Why did the author go to Bridport? Answer is, the author went to Bridport in search of Mrs. Jim MacPherson. He wanted to give her back her important letters. Question number 9. How old was Mrs. MacPherson now? Where was she? Mrs. MacPherson was now 101 years old. She was in the conservatory of a nursing home. Question number 10. Who did Connie MacPherson think her visitor was? Answer is Connie MacPherson thought that her visitor was her husband Jim MacPherson. Question number 11. Which sentence in the text shows that the visitors did not try to hide his identity? Answer is the sentence in the text is I explained about the desk, about how I found it. Question number 12. Why do you think the desk had been sold and when? Question number 12. Why do you think the desk had been sold and when? Answer is the desk must have been sold when Connie's house had burnt. The table had been damaged by fire as well as water. The fireman must have used water to douse the flames of the burning table. For how long do you think Connie had kept Jim's letter? Give reason for your answer. Answer, Connie had kept Jim's letter for a long time. She had received it on January 25, 1915. Jim had written it on December 26, 1914. At that time, Jim was an officer, a captain in the English Army. A captain in the army is always a young man. It means that Jim's wife Connie must have also been young. In the story, she is 101. It means the letter was about 70 to 75 years old. There are hints also. The table containing the letter was found in a junk shop. Again, it indicates its oldness. Question number 14. What is Connie's Christmas present? Why is it the best Christmas present in the world? Answer. Connie's Christmas present was the letter which the author had brought for her. However, in her muddled state, she thought that it was not the author but her Jim. She called the author Jim and made him sit beside her. She kissed him on the cheek. For her husband had returned after such a long time. So she said that it was the best Christmas present she had ever got. Question number 15. Do you think the title of this story is suitable for it? Can you think of any other title? The title of the story is quite suitable. The best Christmas present in the world refers to the present for the old lady. Otherwise, also the story is woven around Christmas. However, it is always possible to find alternate title. For example, War can be another title. The story is, after all, an anti-war story. Christmas could also be a title because the story narrates two important Christmas days. I hope this video will be helpful to you. Thank you.